स्टूडेंट्स 11th स्टैंडर्ड केमिस्ट्री यूनिट 14 हेलो अल्केन्स एंड हेलो एरेन्स பார்த்துட்டு இன் திஸ் வீடியோ we learn about E2 elimination reactions. That E2 elimination reaction is a following request. So I am taking a primary alkyl halide. Primary alkyl halide and a second it is a first step reactions. First step reactions and third one is a it is needed a strong electrophile, strong base, otherwise strong base. So I'm taking a alcoholic KOH and the next this reaction is depends upon that two step reaction. So the rate of the reaction is depends upon alkyl halide and the base. Alkyl halide and base. So order of the reaction is second order. So our E1 means E stands for elimination and 2 is a bimolecular elimination reactions. So what's the name of the reactions? Bimolecular elimination reactions. Okay, so this is a bimolecular elimination reactions. This reaction is depends upon the two reactant. What are the reactant I'm taking here? So generally we are taking that 1, 2, 3. Okay, this is a chlorine atom. So this chlorine atom is attached with the first carbon. So that carbon name is alpha. This is our beta. This is our gamma carbon. So I can satisfy that hydrogen atom on each carbon atom is having a CH2. This is a CH because CH2 group this I will add it here. So now it is a CH3. So I am reacting with the KOH in the presence of alcoholic because this is a strong base we needed. So the strong base we needed, the reaction is should be already told what is the elimination reactions. The elimination means it's a removed. So but the happening here, this ion will be, this chlorine will be removed. This chlorine will be removed, it taking that pair of electrons. So this electron will be shifted here, the hydrogen will be lost. So this OH will be separated here, OH ion, here K plus ion. So OH minus is reacting with them, it will form a H2O and the remaining will be a KBr. So remaining of the product I can balance each reactant 1, 2, 3. So there are three carbons. So three carbon is now already it is having a 3-methyl group, but here only one substituent, two substituent. So now this bond will be shifted here. This bond will be shifted here to form a double bond. So the double bond group is attaching. So remaining will be CH2. So name of the compound is called a propene. So in IUPAC name or common name, what do you say? 1-propene. 1-propene. So the total number of carbon is 3. Is a root word is a prop, and double bond is present in between that first and the second. So numbering you put a 1-propene. 1-propene is name of the product. So let us see what's happening here. We are taking a primary alkyl halide. Primary alkyl halide means the name of the compound is 1-chloropropane. This I am writing on the IUPAC name, but I am taking common name is propyl chloride. This is our IUPAC naming. This is our common name. Okay, so this compound react with a strong basis of KOH. The KOH is spreaded into two form, K plus OH minus. This K plus is attacked with the more relative negative atom of chlorine. So the chlorine is away from the electron is away from that from the substituent. So it will form a Cl minus. So the Cl minus and the K plus is attacked, it will form a KCl. It will form a KCl compound. KCl compound. So remaining this hydrogen will be, this unstable, so it is a more positive cation. That the hydrogen will be lost, this bond will be shifted here, it will form a one propene compound because this is having carbon. You all the structural formula, all the molecular formula, you can satisfy the carbon valence is a 4. Okay, this is the E2 elimination reactions. This E2 elimination is also depends upon the temperature. It is also depends upon the temperature. The temperature will be is increased, the reaction will product also increases. The stability is depends upon the temperature. Temperature is increased, it is also an endothermic reaction. Thank you for watching this video, students.